Time has finally come, boys and girls. We're here to end the monster series with the final video, the final installment of this series. Yonko's versus Admiral. Who is stronger? We're going to settle the score in this video. For people that don't know, it's been a three-part series with Admirals, Yonko's, and now Yonko's versus Admirals. If you haven't watched the first two, you can go watch the first two, then come back to this video. Or you can just watch this video, then go watch the first two. They're just my overview on the Admirals and my overview on the Yonko, and now we're pitting them against each other to determine who is stronger. Now, I know the consensus is that the Yonko are way stronger than the Admirals, but I think the Admirals can put up a great fight against the Yonko, and today we're going to go through some things, like I said, and determine at the end who is actually stronger. What I'm going to do is rank all of these characters at the end as well. So this is going to be part discussion, part ranking. So I'm going to rank all the Admirals and all the Yonko. So Garp is going to be included, as well as Sengoku, Whitebeard, and I guess we can throw Shiki in there as well. First, for the Admirals, it's a lot going on with the power scaling, because we have new Admirals, we have established Admirals, we have old Admirals, but I guess there's a consistency around the Admiral level, which is these people are powerful, they have a lot of prowess and not that many weaknesses, if any at all. For the older Admirals, it is difficult to rank them because they're no longer in their prime, and they were competing against the Pirate King in their prime, so it's hard to scale them for today. But let's talk about something really quickly that I didn't address in the other videos, and that is the passage of time and how the Admirals and the Yonko have progressed over time. Now, for the most part, people feel that this generation is weaker than the previous generation. The previous generation being Roger, Shiki, Whitebeard, Garp, Sengoku, Kong. It's almost very hard not to agree with that due to the fact that they have several feats. The fact that Roger was the Pirate King, Whitebeard was the strongest man in the world, Sengoku and Garp, those are legends of the Marines. Garp is known as the hero of the Marines before Roger's time. Garp was able to take down the Rocks Pirates, and that's confirmed to have Big Mom and Kaido on the same crew. The important details we have no idea about, but I'm sure Garp had assistance with taking down that entire crew. Of course, he's the person that gets credit for it, but the world government is not somebody we can trust. I mean, they eradicated an entire void century. We know about that. And even in real time in the story, they changed things in the newspaper to match their interest, to fit whatever agenda they have going on. According to them, Jack was dead. We know how they covered up the crocodile thing. So trusting the world government is difficult, and I damn sure don't trust Sengoku or Garp. The reason why I don't trust Garp, because he's a D and he's working for the world government. I know Saul was as well, but Saul defected at the end. And Sengoku, we know Sengoku is a ruthless guy when need be. We saw that he gave the orders for Ahara, essentially. But regardless, it's hard to scale these characters. But for the most part, people put Garp and Sengoku on that level. So why is the consistency there between the Admirals of the past, but now the Admirals of today? We're downscaling them and saying the Yonko are way powerful than that. I really find it interesting, out of all characters, Oda said Akainu in 1 year he would find a One Piece if he was the main character, or something to that effect. Think about that. In 1 year, somebody that's not Yonko level would find the One Piece. Essentially what Oda is saying, based on Akainu's ambition, drive, wherewithal, and just overall strength, he would lead someone to find the One Piece in 1 year. Mind you, Big Mom has been actively searching for the One Piece. We're not sure if Kaido wants the One Piece, but he does have a poneglyph. Shanks, that's another person that's up in the air, but for Akainu in 1 year, we give no credence to that at all. Again, everything I say about Akainu, I'm saying about Aokiji as well, because I believe they're on the same level, the same tier. It took a lot for one to overcome the other, so for them, they're just neck and neck, as far as I'm concerned. The major thing against the Admirals is that the showings they have had has not been as impressive as the showings of the Yonko. The Yonko, again, they are overwhelming forces. They are immovable objects, unstoppable forces. However, they do have their blemishes. I pointed them out in the Yonko video, but for Big Mom, it's her stamina and endurance. She has to eat at some point. For Shanks, there are several things about him that we don't know, but for me, presumably, he is the strongest Yonko. For Kaido, he is the world's strongest creature. However, he has been captured before, tortured before. Again, they could not kill him, but we know there's something to that. Shanks was able to intercept him, and Shanks is the most regular person out of all these monsters. Blackbeard has two devil fruits, and Whitebeard, he's Whitebeard, okay? People talk about Whitebeard and Blackbeard, and we saw Blackbeard shown versus Whitebeard, and a lot of people feel like if Blackbeard's crew didn't jump in, Blackbeard would have died. I don't think so. Again, Whitebeard got a good hit in on Blackbeard. Blackbeard, again, he takes punishment and he overcomes it easily, right? Regardless, do you think Blackbeard showing at Marineford is better than Akainu showing at Marineford? I get it. Blackbeard did not have Whitebeard's fruit yet, and of course, it's been 2 years since then. Then why did he run from Akainu? If you're that powerful, why did you run? People were saying, Well, Akainu had an entire fleet with him. Why does a fleet matter? It's just Akainu. You have Blackbeard, Shiryu, Avalo Pizarro, Katarina Devon, amongst others. The most notorious pirates of level 6. You can't take down one admiral? And you have a Yonko and the entire crew? And more than likely, another admiral or vice admiral wasn't there. There were no other prominent people there, and they did not want to engage with Akainu. For Whitebeard at Marineford. Again, people said that Whitebeard was holding back at Marineford. I think initially, Whitebeard was showing some restraint. But when someone uses heaven and earth, I'm sorry, there's no more restraint there. He literally almost capsized the entirety of Marineford. People were falling and dying. Yeah, you can say Whitebeard cared about his crew, but heaven and earth? It tilted the entirety of Marineford. At that point, I don't think Whitebeard gave a fuck about what was going on. He was just trying to sink it all. And of course, we had that moment when he tried to use his devil fruit and it couldn't penetrate whatever that material was at Marineford. And again, the admirals were able to stop his shockwave when he was trying to get to the platform. We know for a fact Aokiji and Akainu and Kizaru, because he was trolling the entire time, they were holding back. We saw what happened to Punk Hazard. Akainu was not using his full force because in his interactions with Whitebeard, he told him to stop destroying Marineford. Again, and that's where the Navy and a lot of their families live. Marineford is an island, so they were trying to protect it. And Whitebeard told them constantly, try to protect it then. Where Whitebeard was actively trying to destroy Marineford. Akainu in a place where he doesn't have to give a fuck, and he can go straight out, full out magma eruption? I think things are playing out a lot differently. And I know a lot of people place Akainu on that Yonko level because of his showing at Marineford, but how can you not do the same for Aokiji? And as much as we overrate Kizaru's devil fruit, how can you not do the same for him? Was it the showing versus really? Was it the fact that he got a scratch? How did he get the scratch? Kizaru being the troll that he is, even after Rayleigh told him he would not let him go anywhere, he tries to use his technique Yatamura to travel, and Rayleigh strikes the light, and that's where Kizaru got the scratch. He did not get the scratch from paying attention. And for Rayleigh stopping him for a few minutes, would you not expect that of a Yonko's right hand? The Pirate King's right hand? Of course Kizaru's not going to be able to overwhelm Rayleigh immediately, but we saw Rayleigh was sweating, Rayleigh was on the defensive, but I expect Rayleigh to be able to stop Kizaru for more than 2 minutes, right? So let's please stop using that, because Kizaru literally stopped paying attention to Rayleigh, was about to leave, and Rayleigh stopped him. That's how he got that scar, or that small scratch. It's not even a scar because it's no longer there. It's just a fucking scratch. Whitebeard versus Akainu is hard to measure that. Again, Akainu was holding back considerably. He could only do simple attacks against Whitebeard, and for someone of that caliber, you really can't hold back. So I think Akainu was definitely stronger than Whitebeard at Marineford. Marineford is a hard place to try to scale people because it's a war and a lot's going on. So sometimes you just have to use your own headcanon and everything you've seen in the story to place these characters in certain places. Again, I think Whitebeard would lose to Aokiji, Kizaru, and Akainu how he was at Marineford. He was still considerably powerful, but I think he would lose to every single one of them. He was Admiral level, for sure. But based on what happened at Marineford, how Whitebeard, every time he interacted with them for the most part, he was overwhelmed and he had to be saved. Again, the last part with Akainu caught Akainu off guard. Akainu still managed to take half his head off. And then we saw what Akainu did after the fact. Give me the Admirals over Whitebeard at that point. And again, this is no disrespect to Whitebeard, but we have to look at it rationally. Whitebeard was not the same man that he was in the past. It was referenced several times at Marineford via numerous interactions at Marineford. Once the Marineford series comes back, then I'll cover Whitebeard and his strength at Marineford. Personally, I feel like every other Yonko would perform better than Whitebeard did at Marineford. And Whitebeard was amazing. He just couldn't do the things that he normally would. Every time Ace was about to get executed, he did not save Ace one time. It was Crocodile, then Luffy again. Whitebeard was not in the position to protect his family anymore. A sad tale, but we'll cover it another time. I'm sure people are saying, this entire video you're talking about how strong the admirals are, how the admirals can stand up to the Yonko. I mean, yeah, because the Yonko are already at the top of it and people view them as the strongest forces in the world, the strongest characters in the world. Now, for the most part, the admirals and Yonko, we place in the top 10 when we're ranking characters. We have a few outliers in Dragon and Mihawk, but the admirals and Yonko, those are consistent people in the top 10. Now, quickly before we rank these characters, people were talking about how many admirals would it take down a Yonko. Now, it depends on where you place Whitebeard, okay? How far do you think Whitebeard was from the other Yonko? Now, think about Marineford, which I hate using, but that's the only thing we can go off of at this point. If Akainu and Aokiji were to attack Whitebeard at the same time, could they take him down? Or how quickly would they take him down? How long would Whitebeard last versus Aokiji and Akainu? There were moments in the war in which Akainu got a free shot in on Whitebeard, and then he just stopped and then Fodder came in and attacked Whitebeard. A little fishy to me. I'm not sure why Akainu would stop attacking Whitebeard, but whatever. But if it's Akainu and Aokiji at the same time, Marineford is a lot shorter than it was. Now for the prime Yonko, the Yonkos in their prime. Big Mom, it's hard to say because of her cravings, and I think as she's gotten older, they've gotten considerably worse. That's just how aging works. How would Aokiji and Akainu do against Big Mom? I think for them taking down Big Mom again, it would be a win for the two admirals. Big Mom, of course, she has Prometheus and Zeus, but for Akainu and Aokiji, them combining and going against a Yonko, as formidable as the Yonko are, they have so many ways in which they can incapacitate these Yonko. And again, I'm using the two strongest admirals, so they're like, why not Fujitora and Green Bull? But Fujitora and his gravity powers, we saw that Zoro was able to get out of his gravity, Luffy as well as Sabo. So for Fujitora, I think he's scaled slightly lower than the original three, but he's still very powerful. I think Fujitora and Green Bull, they would probably struggle against the Yonko. I'm being honest, I think they would struggle against the Yonko, but they would probably win high diff. I think it would be a high diff fight for two admirals like Fujitora and Green Bull to take out a Yonko. Again, Green Bull, we have no idea of his combat prowess, but they said he was on the same level as Fujitora. They are almost identical, and that's what Oda has been trying to show, that they came in together and they were somewhat on the same level. That's why they became admirals. Not because they were on the same level, but Oda is trying to portray that they achieved a certain level in which it was okay for them to become admirals. In ways, he's viewing them as parallels, and they're set up to be of similar level, of similar strength. A lot of people are saying, okay, well, for Shanks, how do they take Shanks down? Like, we don't know anything about Shanks, but we just have to estimate Shanks is on the level of the other Yonko. They have been in a stalemate for years, so you have to assume they're around the same level. For Kaido, that's the interesting one, because Kaido, again, he's been captured before and was not able to be killed or anything. So for Kaido, why weren't they able to puncture and kill Kaido? Why couldn't anyone do this? We still don't know who was able to injure Kaido. We still don't know the reason behind his enormous strength and how that happened. And for this, we have to wait and see exactly how that would play out. But trust me, Kaido has been defeated before. He just hasn't been killed. So just because you can't kill someone doesn't mean you can't defeat them. My final thing, I promise, this is before going to the rankings, and this is the end of it. People always say, well, if the world government is that strong, why don't it just take two admirals or three admirals and go to take out a Yonko? Guys, let's think about it really quickly. The world government, they control most of the One Piece world, right? They are in control of most of the One Piece world. And for them to pick up their forces and stroll into a Yonko's territory to take down a Yonko, do you understand how vulnerable that leaves them? They're trying to maintain the structure of an entire ecosystem, and you're asking them to pick up, send forces to a Yonko's territory? It's not Yonko versus admirals. It's the Yonko versus the world government. The admirals, they're the strongest fighting force, but the Yonko, they have hella territory and hella allies. If Whitebeard strolled up to Marineford with just his crew, they could literally send just the admirals out there, maybe a few vice admirals, and they're winning. If Whitebeard came to Marineford, just his crew, his commanders, and him, they could send the admirals out there and the vice admirals out there, and they're winning. That's it. They're winning. But the fact that you'd have to send at least three admirals out there speaks to the strength of the Yonko's crew. A Yonko's crew is impressive. You have several characters that should be able to hold off admirals, and that's not a bad thing. So while the world government has the power to take out each Yonko 1v1, it leaves them too vulnerable for other things. What if someone attacks the world government at that point? What if another Yonko attacks while they're attacking the Yonko? It's too many variables. Kaido tried to attack Marineford while everything was going on. Shanks was the one who stopped that. If Kaido had attacked Marineford, I'm not sure how things are playing out. When we get back to the Marineford series, we'll talk about that. What if Kaido attacked Marineford? And by then, we should know more about Kaido's crew. But at this point, the Yonko versus admirals, I do think for the most part, the Yonkos are, on an average, stronger than the admirals, because some admirals kind of bring the level down. However, they are top tier admirals that could fight on par with the Yonko. So without further ado, let's rank these characters. So quickly, how I rank these characters, and I'm including Rayleigh in this one as well, just because Rayleigh is someone they consider as a Yonko level character. And I guess I can Mihawk as well. To a 10, I have Rayleigh. 9, I have Garp. 8, Sengoku. 7, Big Mom. Mihawk. 6, 5, Blackbeard. 4, Aokiji. 3, Akainu. 2, Kaido. And 1, Shanks. From 5 to 1, it could go any way. with Blackbeard, Aokiji, Akainu, Kaido, and Shanks. From 6 to 10, I think whoever's higher would beat whoever's behind them. Now, this is overall strength. I'm not taking into consideration specific matchups because then it makes it more convoluted, but this is just overall strength. I know a lot of people are going to be surprised that I have Mihawk over Big Mom, but I have my reasons. That'll be discussed in a Mihawk video at some point, but I think my perspective on Mihawk is changing a bit. And that's due to some things that I've been thinking about recently, but a video will be coming soon on that. So yeah, those are my thoughts on Yonko versus Admiral. I think Yonkos are stronger than Admirals on average, but I think certainly there are Admirals, even including current Admirals, that could beat a Yonko if they were allowed to go all out. Currently, I believe Aokiji and Akainu for sure. Kizaru maybe. Green Bull and Fujitora? No, I don't think so. And we can wait until Oda gives us more from Green Bull before coming to that conclusion. But again, Oda has been trying to portray Green Bull and Fujitora around the same level since they're new Admirals, but we'll see. Guys, leave your thoughts below. Please, again, be respectful. This is the end of the Monster series, the Yonkos and Admirals. This is how I feel about it. My perspective may change the more we find out, or even when I go back and read certain things. But for right now, this is how I feel about everything. The next three videos will contain different subject matter, of course, excluding the One Piece chapter reviews. If you would like to vote on the series going forward, please become a patron, because I'm going to have series ideas that I'm going to be making that I'm going to have my patrons vote on. But first, I have to drop this Hunter x Hunter video, because that was the next video up in the queue, and it's been so long, I have to drop that video. But after that, it's going to be videos that you can vote on, and it's going to be a series where I'm talking about a specific thing in three different parts, covering different perspectives, because One Piece is a series of various perspectives, or varying perspectives. And for my current patrons, I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you for the support. It helps me keep this channel going. And please join the Discord as well. We have a lot of fun in there. The link will be in the description box down below. And yeah, that's about it, guys. Leave your feedback below. I would like to hear your feedback. Again, a comments video is coming. I will drop that before I drop the next series of videos. Just going through your comments and giving my perspective on some of your guys' comments. I can't respond to all the comments I get, which is a blessing, honestly, but I want to highlight all the people that have been commenting. So thank you guys so much again. Please like the video, because that helps out the channel a lot. If you like the video, YouTube promotes it more, and therefore we can grow the channel and have more fun, right? Subscribe if you enjoy the content. If you're not going to subscribe, leave feedback as to why you're not subscribing. That would help a lot, because then I can improve my videos, improve my content overall. And that's the goal every time I make a video. So, but thank you guys so much. I really appreciate the support. Again, like, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.